What's up? It's Brandon with PhysioTrader here. We've got about 10 seconds before the market open. I've got Palantir up on the screen, really watching a lot of other things on my other screen, so just trying to see what happens. Looks like there might be a little delay over here. My other screen's showing big red bar. This one's just waiting to see. I know Palantir's up, but it's really not what I'm watching. I've got my fishing orders out. Not orders, but my fishing window up. So I'm basically looking at nine different stocks at the same time. And as soon as something catches my eye, if anything, I will look. So I had a goal of shorting this at 55.50, hoping that it would open up a little bit higher, go higher, then fall. Man, that's a beautiful drop. But it just did. There wasn't a trade plan that could have occurred that was safe, effective. Palantir's dropping. Although from here, looking at this bar, 35.90s to 35.20, 70 cent spread compared to the one I was just on. Mean, this is what, 55 and change. I mean, that is a massive drop. It's not shortable. I did not realize. It's not even shortable, which is what I was interested in. So locates, which means I could pay a fee to get it. So, well, I have no interest in going long on this thing. So, with that being said, I will likely Tesla. Okay. What you got for us? Not really getting to play with anything just yet. The SPY doesn't really show me anything worthwhile, so just to kind of show you what's going on here. We're not really getting a lot of movement here. A lot of these other stocks aren't showing me any, feasible trade plans. I just can't work with that. Sure, if you would have shorted at any point, it would have worked out, but not necessarily a good trade plan. Oh, wow. And Tesla. 19. That's quite a savage drop right there. Wait a minute, hold on, hold on. So it looks like, I don't know if my light speed charts are really delayed. looks like my Lightspeed ones might be more accurate, and my Schwab charts are delayed by like a whole minute. It's costing me a trade plan. I was actually looking to short this over 35.50. Didn't get there, but I actually got distracted. Thing just keeps dropping to 165, 150. Whew. That's painful. That is painful. Seems like the whole market right now is dropping. Just kind of stinks. I want to be a part of it. But at this point, I need things to calm down. So Tesla's getting some upward move. Uber doing? Bummer. I think Uber had earnings yesterday. I don't think they were favorable. Looks like a good play, but still don't like it. I would like to have seen this thing go up, you know, closer to 35.50 range. It's not getting the same pop it had a couple days ago. Uber. Quite overextended on the 5 minute, even the 15 minute. I mean, that's awfully overextended here. A lot of orders going through, not moving at all. Wouldn't be surprised if this thing snaps up a solid dollar. SPY showing us some strength. Palantir failing to hold on to into strength. GameStop's just grinding. What, 50? Yeah, 50 to 55. It's beautiful. This thing is still so choppy, so fast. Pretty low. If this wants to bring it down to whoa, that's ridiculous. Oh, well, at that point, it's not even a valid plan anymore. GameStop with a failure. Real unfortunate for anyone in there. Ouch. Not really getting anything I like over here. So got my eye on Neo. I almost want to take it for a breakout, but last time I took it for 63.50 or 64.50, it just collapsed on me. I don't necessarily want to short it either, though. This one just has a way of breaking your heart if you're short on it. I do like that it's starting to put in higher lows. And Tesla shooting like a rocket. Surprisingly, this thing didn't take off with it. Following a line pretty well. I actually think this thing is gonna flush. That's 62.30. But it very well may just pop out of this thing. Let's see what the market wants to do. be looking in the wrong spots at the wrong times. That's quite a recovery right there. I do like this rolling over, kind of pinch it together a little bit there for a failed break, 6250, and then falling down, hopefully close to this moving average. But I could be wrong. Okay. That is while you wait for confirmation on these trades. I'm just going to go ahead and pause, and I think I'm just going to restart it when I actually enter a trade, just because this is going to get long and I might not even make a trade. Got an open order out here at 6242. It looked like it was going to get hit, but now I'm not so sure it is. I'm looking for just a bounce. I don't necessarily think it's going to get all the way down to 35. Alright, I'm going to pause again. Going to end up canceling that order. Got an order out there at 6239. Might hit it. Wow. Alright, so got those. I will capture more if it wants to go down, but if it does want to go up, I will certainly take those as well. You know what? SPY appears to be dropping pretty aggressively. I'm going to get those. Here is 6227. All right, here we go. So my first sell order is at 43 over here on the ask. 43. Can we get 44? Good. So we got those. Took another 100 off. right, so took those. It just didn't look like it was going to be a favorable trade. I didn't want to lose out, so definitely would have made money had I just scaled out. It would have been, I don't know, another like 10 or 20 bucks. Maybe I got a little nervous out of here, but I did not want to take this bounce and then ride it down any further. So let's see. Oh wait, come on, yeah. So let's see, it never got over 51. As high as 41. Apple's dropping pretty aggressively. $1.50 for Apple, that's pretty big. And this is why I'm glad I got out. Neo looks like it is. Turns out it looks like I got out of the best spot in, you know, the current future. You know, I don't know what the future is going to show. Maybe this thing just holds strong at 62 and it just beast mode up. Or if it fails, it may fail further down. We will see. But it looks like the SPY is showing some action right now. So that's kind of what gave us that drop. The SPY is equally as holding, but if this thing wants to fall further, that will be fun. Still on 1 minute candles, so if you can kind of see it right here, what I'm on, ticker, this number 42 just shows that's how many candles you can currently see, how many minutes back you are. Well, not minutes, but candles. Almost looks like 62.10. Yeah, glad I got out. So, wasn't, you know, in hindsight, I should have just got out at 43. That was apparently the best. So, 45. So, it's the best it got anyway. Okay, I made one more trade. It actually happened so quick, I didn't even think about getting the recording going, but made one more, gonna call it a day. Nothing spectacular, but really nothing's just going on in the markets right now that's worth my time, and I gotta go to my day job. So thanks for watching.